Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, and in this video, I'll be going over one of my most recent projects, a 3D printed pellet extruder. First, I'll go over the purpose, and then I'll talk about the design, and lastly, the costs. I've got a lot to talk about in a short period of time, so let's get to it. So I'm sure you may have seen some pellet extruder designs in the past. Some famous ones include Green Boy 3D and Mahor XYZ pellet extruders. And if you haven't heard of them, I would highly recommend you go check them out after this video, as they have been a great influence for my design. Anyways, pellet extruders, like the name suggests, print with pellets of raw material rather than long strands of filament found in traditional consumer 3D printers. Pellet extruders are more common in large industrial machines where high volumes of plastic are used. It is good to note that plastic pellets are cheaper to access than filament. In addition to that, pellet extruders have the capability to directly 3D printed shreds. Granted, they are small enough for the pellet extruder. Now, let's get on to my works. Alright, so we are now here in Autodesk Fusion, my primary CAD software. And this is my lovely pellet extruder design. Definitely a work in progress. Let's start off with the hardware. You can see the main extrusion system is pretty straightforward. There's an extruder auger that feeds filament into the extruder barrel, which is then extruded with the standard V6 nozzle. One key aspect of plastic extrusion is that the auger is variable. You can visualize it here, how there's a cone shape running through the auger. This compresses the plastic. There's more volume at the feed end than there is at the extrusion end, which compresses the plastic. And that removes air bubbles, improving print quality. Of course, some plastic extrusion designs use traditional augers, like wood augers, that don't compress the plastic. But that gets the job done, but not the most optimal. And since you made it this far, let's talk about potential costs. The extruder kit hardware found on AliExpress costs around $70, and the NEMA 17 motor with the gearbox goes for around $40 on Amazon. Some miscellaneous hardware like the brass offsets, shaft collars, and screws would go for $10. And the fans, I just copied the ones from the prusa i3 mk3s, so if you have that printer, you could probably repurpose those, or you could just buy them for probably $20 or so. To sum it up, the total is around $170 US, but that is from suppliers and for one-off. So if this was mass-produced and produced in a more efficient manner, you could probably get up to, or down to, $100. And that isn't too bad considering some filament hot ends go for that same amount, and the pellet extruder will save you money on filament, so you'll be better off in the long run. And that's the gist of it. I hope you enjoy this video, and since you've made it this far, I know you are worthy of my mission, Operation Perpetual Printing. I am working to make recycling more accessible to average people like you and me. Check out my works in making 3D printed shredders with the playlist here. Feel free to support the movement with the donation link in the description. All of the transactions of the nonprofit are 100% transparent, so you'll be ensured your generosity is spent towards an honest cause. With that said, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.